Hey everybody, ChristopherOdd here, and welcome to a game called M.E.R.C. It just released on Early Access, and I thought some of you guys may enjoy it, so I'd like to show it to you. M.E.R.C. is a real-time tactical combat game. You can think of some of the elements from XCOM, like you're controlling a group of soldiers, you can take cover, you upgrade your soldiers, they have classes, they have subclasses, they have weapons, armor, gear, all that kind of thing. But it's all happening in real time. There's also a cool thing where you can play this co-op. So you can take in part of your squad to somebody else's mission and help them and vice versa. It's really interesting. For an early access game that just released, it's actually quite polished. There's a lot going on. But I thought I would take you through the first couple levels to give you an idea of what it's like and check this out. So, without further ado, this is M.E.R.C. by Tiny Mob Games. The year is 2124. Ravaged by decades of war, the world was reduced to a toxic wasteland. Those that survived found solace within one of the last standing cities. That city is Neotopia, a megacity under the collective control of megacorporations, like you see here, Raycor, Cetus Cargo. This area up here, this is called Sprawl. It's a colossal network of slums segregated by a great wall. In the following years, the two cities clashed over the waterways. The peacekeeping organization Themis approached both sides with a truce. Sprawl would share its waterways with Neotopia. In exchange, the corporations would share their wealth. But one corporation, Raycor, they refused the deal, attempting a coup against their former allies. The other corporations retaliated, striking Raycor down. As punishment for its betrayal, the corporation was dismantled, its CEO mysteriously vanishing. Yet now, a mysterious group threatens to unseat the truce between the two cities. In response, Themis has hired a group of mercenaries to investigate the slums, which is where we come in. As the survival of a civilization hangs in the balance, one commander will keep the peace. Or attempt to. Okay, so let's create a new account, shall we? Let's go ahead and call us the Odd Squad, super creative, I know. Make sure we check legal for name conflicts, naturally. I don't know. What do we want to do for an emblem? We could do like the knight, we could do the star. Let's do the, I like the viper. That's kind of cool. Let's stay with the white, keep it clean. Okay, so this is like our mission control or command center, as it's called. There's a lot going on here. I'm not gonna go through every detail just yet because I want to show you the first mission. Then we'll go through some of the details before we go into the second mission. The first mission's very quick, in its tutorial style, but it'll give you a decent idea of what the actual gameplay is like. So, without further ado, let's get into the gameplay itself. There is a story in M.E.R.C., and I'm gonna read through, the mission summaries. The cool thing is that, there's story-based missions that are gonna be the same each time that you play it, but there are also side missions that are procedurally generated a la kind of XCOM style, right? So this mission, we have to investigate these blackouts that are happening. We need to find the source of the power disturbances at the Ether Sector Power Station. And this is being told to us by the CEO of Themis. Her name is Athena Lee. So here's the briefing. On behalf of Themis, welcome to MercNet, Commander. I'm the organization's director, Athena Lee. We've called upon your services in light of recent events in Sprawl. Someone has been stealing resources from corporate facilities, and despite preliminary investigations, we've not been able to catch the perpetrators. To make matters worse, blackouts are now plaguing Neotopia as Sprawl's hydroelectric facilities have mysteriously begun to fail. Corporations are threatening to suspend payments to Sprawl to cover their lost profits, and workers here are not happy about it. Themis is currently taking steps to organize a Hydro Accord summit to discuss the matter, however. Before we can do so, we must ensure the slums are secure. That's where you come in, Commander. We at Themis have created MercNet, a state-of-the-art tactical system designed to recruit and command mercenary units. Your impressive record during the Channel Riot speaks for itself. We need your skills to lead this program and investigate the source of the disturbances in Sprawl. We currently have reports that one of the hydroelectric facilities is malfunctioning. Seems like a good test mission for you and your squad. Investigate the generator in the Delta Sector and report back with your findings. So, this risk assessment is like a difficulty rating on the mission. We have to find the source of the disturbances. We get 3,000 credits as a reward. If you're looking at the interface here, you can probably figure out what the importance of these credits. And then you gain some reputation, which we'll talk about a little bit later. So, let's get into the mission. Now, there's going to be some pop-ups in the top left corner kind of explaining some of the tutorial aspects, but they go by really quickly, so I may not be able to cover them all. And I hope that they actually voice act it. This is a little robot called AAID that's going to oversee our infiltration. And basically, whatever he sees, we sees. He can mark, like, targets. He can keep us on track of where we need to go. There we go. Biometrics, mark targets, etc. I have to excuse his enthusiasm. He's been very excited to meet you. I barely hibernated last night. I wish he had a sweet voiceover, though, because he actually can be pretty funny at times. So we're going to have our squad explore the station and find the power source. He's basically going to describe what to do. So, really quickly, before we take off, a couple of things to note. You do notice we have four soldiers out here. We've got Dog Pound, Redwood, Gopher, and Thunder. They're all different like classes. So we have an engineer, we have a sniper, we have an assault, we have like our assault here, and I believe this is our heavy class. You can't control them individually, but you can control them by team. So each team has two. You can tab between Alpha and Bravo. If you hit Q, you get all teams. You right-click to move to any destination. He wants us to take cover here. Anytime we move to something that you can take cover behind, the units will automatically do so. He's asking us to just move now out of cover, which is cool. So I'm going to tab to Alpha team. We can move them individually. If we wanted, we could send Bravo team way over here, but we're just going to group up and run through the tutorial mission rather quickly so you can see what things are like. Notice the visuals are actually pretty nice. Like, I think it's quite polished for an early access game. They were saying that they're hoping to be in early access for like 3 to 6 months. And the only thing really missing is to finish some of the story missions and complete the entire narrative. Otherwise, it's like a pretty polished game. They will obviously work on some of the abilities, make sure that everything's balanced, and just like little technical things here and there. But in my couple of hours with it, I haven't had any technical issues. It's run great, and it's fun. It's a nice little change up from a lot of the XCOM that I've been playing. It's just a different tactical combat approach, having everything be real time. So this is a door switch. So there's a couple of things that we can interact with in the environment. You just click on them and there we go. Walking, ducking, opening doors. We're practically unstoppable. You're right. Let's take some cover. We do have some enemies here. We do have the ability to use like this bullet time where we slow down time a little bit. I'm gonna have Alpha team attack on the right, and I'm gonna have Bravo team attack on the left. We do have a bunch of abilities that we can use. I will use them during this mission, although they're really not necessary. This mission is very basic, but it does ramp up in the second one. But as far as the tutorial goes, I think it does a pretty good job. And one of the cool things that you could, like, we could have done something different there. We could have had Alpha squad stay there. We could have flanked with Bravo squad or vice versa. Our Bravo team is our sniper and our engineer, who's currently got proximity mines and EMP grenades. And yeah, all of these abilities are pretty cool and they fit the classes really well. So as we're going towards this door, let's kind of walk through these. So we've got frag grenades and suppressing fire. Both are pretty self-explanatory. We've got RPGs and a body hugger. Body hugger is like a homing missile, basically. You target an enemy and it's going to hit them regardless of where they go. We've got headshots, so it's like better crits. And cloaking, we can go invisible for a second. Proximity mines, as you would imagine. And EMP grenades, probably better against electronic or robotic enemies. One of the things I really like about the squad is that instead of having individual kind of key bindings for each soldier, everything is presented right here. So no matter where you are, you can select any skill and you can use it right away. I just think it's a really cool and easy to use interface. So it wants us to open up this crate, which we're gonna do. It's been explaining some of the story in the top left. I don't mean to distract from that at all, and I really enjoy a good story, but I just want to kind of explain the mechanics and stuff to you guys as we go. So in these loot boxes that we will find, sometimes we'll find money, sometimes we'll find refills for some of our consumables here, because as you can see, they only have like a couple of uses, right? Here we've got a heal, so we'll heal our squad to 100%, which doesn't really matter because we didn't take a lot of damage, and then we'll open the door and proceed. But when you find this out in the field and you find like, you can heal for 25, 50, 75, and 100, I believe. And once you do, that's pretty helpful because in further missions, we will definitely start to take damage. So we have an enemy coming up here. We could all just grab the cover back here. That's fine. And I'll slow this down again in combat, just so we can kind of see things happen. If they're not gonna run at us, let's take a headshot, start it off this way. He's down. We might be able to just ambush them completely. Let's try and get their attention. Here we go. So I'm gonna slow this down. Let's actually throw a grenade back there. We have tons of range. It's just spacebar to enter that little bullet time. They're actually gonna run out of it. So let's go ahead and use the body hugger. And we could cloak up as well. There, let's cloak around. They literally cannot see us. You can use this tactically if you'd like. And they drop loot as well. So he's got some more grenades, which is great, because we just used one. But yeah, you can slow things down. There's no penalty for doing so, which I think is pretty cool. But you also, you don't have to use that aspect. To rotate the camera, you can just click and drag, or you can use A and D. Let's go ahead and check this thing out. If you look around the levels, you'll find these little signs, and they're basically codex entries. So this is a codex entry for the Hydro Accords. Once we go back to like mission control, I'll show you guys some of the codex entries and how that works. Basically provides backstory on some of the corporations, some of the enemies that we run into, and it's all random. Every time that I've come through this area, the codex entries have been different, so you're not always gonna find out the same information every time, which is cool. Keeps things fresh on like story missions that would normally be the same. So, yeah. Okay, nice work. Those mystery soldiers have cool masks, but they've got nothing on you. You got that right. Be ready for anything. Let's open the door. I don't see anything off to the left. Now, we see an enemy up here. We'll do a little bit of a flank if we can. I'll keep Bravo Team back here, and then let's bring Alpha Team around. Now you'll notice, I actually stopped before we got to the cover. Our guys will stop and actually fire on site in the position that you instruct them to, which is cool. It doesn't, like, things aren't queued up to the point where you can't control your guys. So we see this guy. Let's actually switch back to this squad. And we'll come around and flank him. This is, just to be clear, this is very basic, just to teach people the mechanics. As far as I know... Okay, we're blocked here. Let's head out. Let's take him down. And then we'll switch over to the other squad. Yeah, they already got him. Alright, cool. So let's trigger this. This is gonna unlock the door, and then we can proceed. The next mission that you guys see will be, there'll be significantly more enemies, and you'll have to actually be a little bit more careful. Still early in the game, so it's not crazy hard, but you'll be able to see where some of the difficulty comes into play. All right, so we've got some loot here. Let's go ahead and grab that. And then we've got our extraction zone, so we can take off. That's a super quick introduction to some of the mechanics of Merc. But I'll go through some of the mission control interface stuff now, and then we'll go into the second mission for some more gameplay with more variety and enemies and things like that. Okay, so this is our mission success screen. Obviously covers off our primary objectives, talks about some reputation that we gain with different corporations, and then our rewards down here. So you do earn experience, you do earn ability points. Now there's a couple of things to note just on this screen. You'll see that these guys all have one star. Thunder here has two stars. These names are all randomly generated as well. As far as I can tell, I don't think there's a way to switch them, which as an XCOM guy, I would love to be able to customize these soldiers a bit more with names, but you do have plenty of customization options for their guns, their helmets, body armor, like lower body stuff, so that's pretty cool. The reason I pointed out these stars is because their maintenance fees for these guys are different. You have to kind of pay an upkeep on soldiers that you hire. One star guys are a bit lower, two star guys are a little bit higher. You'll also note that when we go in, Thunder here, she's gonna have not just the engineering class, she's gonna have a sub, kind of a subclass, so we'll check that out in a second. So, Athena is saying, welcome back, Commander. I've gone ahead and analyzed the disruptor you found. It appears that it was tracking or trying to hack into the hydroelectric generator and shut it down. Fortunately, the power stations are all outfitted with top-of-the-line security, so the most this device can do is cause temporary power disruption. This intermittent pattern is consistent with the outages we've been seeing across the five sectors. Now that we know about the existence of these devices, we can send mercenaries to locate and disable them across power stations in sprawl. The discovery of a coordinated group behind these attacks is worrisome. Remember, all of those corporations kind of turned on that Raycor, so just keep that in mind. We still know nothing about who's behind this and why. Those members you encountered were too well outfitted to belong to any slum gang in the area. The only organizations with access to that kind of equipment are the corporations themselves, and despite their notoriously cutthroat reputations, I doubt they'd go as far as to sabotage their own operations to bring down the competition. We'll need to keep an eye out for more of those group members and see if we can figure out what they wanted with the stations. In the meantime, excellent work today, Commander. Your actions have gone a long way in helping to alleviate the tensions between Neotopia and Sprawl. Take some time in the barracks to relax. If any of your units require medical attention, AAID will show you what needs to be done. All right, cool. Every time you can finish a mission, it updates the command center, generates anything that needs to. It gives us some of our communications feed here, which is really cool. Basically just a summary of what we've done and what's to come. So the Codex thing that I talked about, we have a new entry for the Hydro Accords. Our reputation with Themis has increased to light. So you'll notice if you look at Themis now, we get 10% more credits from successfully completing missions. What I don't know is if this is only for completing missions for Themis. Like, we are hired mercenaries, right? So we go out on missions for each of these different groups. I would imagine it's only for Themis missions. Could be wrong, I'm not sure. But it's pretty cool. And for each of these ones that you highlight, you'll see that they all have like corporate rivals and stuff. So depending who you help, that could impact relations with other corporations and things. This could get pretty deep. So I like that they've added this. Let's go through the kind of interface now. So this is mission control. You'll notice at the top we have a bankroll of 13,000. We have weekly upkeep costs of 6,900. This is basically coming from all of our soldiers. So you can see the income that we've generated, not a lot. We can get loans if we need to. We have a payment due in 6 days, which is gonna come up pretty quickly. And then here's our expenditures. So unit salary for the one star soldiers, 4,500. So we have three soldiers. That means each of the one star soldiers is 1,500 bones. The two star soldiers are 2,300. Then we have transport, maintenance, etc. So it's a cool, like, it's kind of like some of the management aspect of the game, which I think is done quite well. Let's go into the barracks and we can show you the soldiers. So Here's Alpha Team, Dog Pound and Redwood. Here's Bravo Team, Gopher and Thunder. These are all of the soldiers that we have right now. Once we get into the Merc Net, you'll see how we can actually recruit soldiers. You can swap these guys in and out too. Like if I wanted to swap Thunder with, say, Dog Pound, I could do that. And now Thunder is in Alpha Team. I actually happen to like the way that it's set up here with more of our support staff in Bravo and then our aggressive guys in Alpha. I think that makes sense so far. But on the screen, you can do a couple of things. You can swap, as I showed you. You can view your soldier. You can see which skills they currently have. I wish that if you hovered, it would tell you what they were. But you can see them when you go into the eye and investigate each soldier. So what I do like is that they've got some stuff being tracked on the left side. They have all the basics like biography, gender, birthday, age, that kind of thing. Then they also track successful missions, some quirks, some interests, just little things like that. It's cool. I just wish that you could customize it. And as far as I know, you can't, which is too bad. But that's okay. Let's go into a couple of other things. So we've got some abilities here, and there's trees for each class. Right now, we've got that suppressing fire. Shoot suppressing fire over a bigger area and cause enemies to cower and cover for longer. And then we've got frag grenades, which blow things up. This is the assault class tree. You can see some of these things are already unlocked from the beginning, and they basically just travels down here. It's not super complex. The most kind of, I guess the thing that's highlighted most far to the right is the thing that you're able to upgrade next, if that makes sense. So we can upgrade frag grenades to frag grenades 2 if we wanted, which means they explode in a bigger area. Or if we wanted, we could improve our reload speeds. There is a difference between special abilities and enhancements. Enhancements are happening basically all the time. You don't have to equip them. Think of them as like PCS chips from XCOM. Special abilities are kind of like your perks from the perk tree of XCOM. I'm not trying to just compare things to XCOM here, but it's what I know, so that's why I compare it to that. We currently have frag grenades 1. Let's go ahead and unlock his ability to frag grenades 2, and then we have to equip it. So if you guys are playing this, don't forget to equip the ability yourself, because you could just upgrade it and leave it, and you'd think you have it, but you do not. You also have the individual loadout for each soldier. So you can see their weapons. He's got a standard assault rifle. It's got a ton of different metrics like damage per second, attack rate, reload time, attack damage, attack range, and ammo capacity. We've got helmets that these guys can wear. We've got vests that they can wear, and then basically boots or leg-based items. And there are class-specific things that you have to buy. So you can't just buy the same helmet for everybody kind of thing. Each class has specific things. Let's finish our upgrades here. So Redwood, let's go ahead and take a look here. We can do, let's upgrade your RPG to RPG 2, generate sight blocking smoke, which is cool. And let's equip that. Let's make sure that we also, let's go back down here and equip it in that slot. There we go. We don't want to lose the body hugger because that is pretty cool. Here's his weapon. He's got the standard heavy rifle. So you can see that. Next we have Gopher. I keep wanting to say Gopher, but it's definitely Gopher. So we have Cloak already. And we've got Headshot. We could upgrade to Headshot 2. I don't see why not. Let's go ahead and equip that. Just as an example, you can see like where this ends up going. Once you get to these green ones, these are some of your talents. So passive ability, you get poison ammo, assisted targeting, maximize cover. You can imagine what those do. This increases your cover bonus protection. This one increases the shooting accuracy of all of your allies. And then this one gives you damage over time with your bullets. So you might be thinking, well, you mowed down those enemies, but that was the first tutorial mission. So the enemies will increase with difficulty as we go. Just to check out, this is her standard sniper rifle. And then last but not least, we have Thunder. So her class is an engineer, but she's got a medic specialty, okay? I actually prefer some of these medic abilities. And what's interesting is every time you start the game, I think this specific person is randomized for their abilities because I've started it where they have the medic abilities equipped right away. And I've started it like this where they don't. So I'm gonna go ahead and upgrade healing to level 2 and we're going to equip that. So let's throw that in there. And then there's also this really cool like shield bubble. So if I go here, special ability mobile shield, let's equip that. We have an available point. I don't know. Maybe we could just, let's do this. Let's upgrade her accuracy. And we'll go from there. So that's basically your unit management. It's pretty straightforward, but you want to keep these guys around because the better they get, and the stronger your team is. If things don't go so well, I'll maybe jump over to the Merc net for right now. Let's say you end up losing a soldier. Then you can go in here and you can hire units. They're not going to show now. After the next mission, there will be some available. But in the Merc net, this is also where you would buy any of your weapons. So you can go in here and upgrade your sniper rifle, for example. You can buy your helmets in here. You can buy chest protection and leg armor, I guess you'd say. You can see what they each do here. It's small improvements, but improvements nonetheless. So I'm gonna go ahead and buy a heavy blast helmet. Let's buy an assault tech helmet. And maybe I'll buy like a better sniper rifle. You can actually filter it up here if you really want to. I don't see a way of comparing it to what we already have on this screen, other than like actually buying it. Once you buy it, then you can do the comparison. Just because we can, I'm gonna go ahead and spend all of our money and just buy a cool sniper rifle to equip on some of our guys, or on one of our guys, I should say. Back to the command center, let's go to the barracks. Let's equip the helmet over here. Let's do the same for our assault. There we go. And then for Goffer, let's go ahead and change this over. You can see the comparison now. So you get an increase to damage, attack rate, attack damage, and ammo capacity, but the reload is a little bit longer. Attack range is the same. So let's go ahead and equip that one. Okay, so next up we have the codex. This is, as you would imagine, codex entries for different things in the game. The two cities that we learned about at the beginning, Sprawl and Neotopia. Mission logs, we learned about generators, the founding of Neotopia, the Hydro Accords, which we found in the actual mission itself. You can go through all of these and just learn as much as you want about the individual corporations, their CEOs. We don't have any corporations unlocked, so maybe I shouldn't spoil that, but you can learn about corporations, hostiles, which is your enemies, the different districts in Sprawl, Manta Intel, mission logs, and just timeline stuff. So it's pretty cool. Lastly, we have the mission lobby. This is where you would connect to do co-op stuff. So it's pretty self-explanatory and it's all explained right here. But basically you do receive any XP that you earn in your missions, which is cool. So you can like send out your squad to help other people. And still have it like impact your actual personal campaign, which I think is really cool. And if this takes off and a bunch of people start playing, that could be really fun, I think. It would be hectic for sure, because you know, you're both trying to do different things, but if you have good communication with a buddy or something, I think it could go pretty well. So that's pretty much it for this area. Let's go back to mission control. Let's go up to our second mission here. And let's see what it's all about. We need to deliver the Titan Bank shipment to the slums. Themesis analysts examine the power diverter your troops retrieve from the power station. It appears to be cobbled together from pieces from various factories around Sprawl, suggesting that something is stealing from the supply line. Cetus Cargo handles the transportation of all goods between Sprawl and Neotopia. After speaking with their operations, I've discovered that some of their shipping drones have gone missing. I've arranged for MercNet to investigate the shipping routes in Sprawl for any suspicious activity. Your troops will be taking over a major delivery to one of the factories in the Delta Sector on behalf of Ethercare. Head to the wall between Sprawl and Neotopia. The shipment will be waiting for you there. You can see our objectives, our rewards, and potential reputation. Shall we? If you guys do have any questions that I haven't answered, let me know, by the way, and I'll try to answer what I can. And if I don't have a clue, then I'll forward it off to the developers, and hopefully they can answer. There are rumors of miners finding remnants from the old world during excavations. An entire civilization buried. Can you imagine what must be out there? Now, one thing that I really wish you could do, I wish you could manipulate the camera a bit more. I would really like to have control over, like, my... Like, I can zoom in like this, but I can't... I just would like a little bit more control over the camera. I'd like to scout ahead with my camera before I send my guys there. Maybe that's just a habitual thing from XCOM, but certainly that would be nice. Okay, so we've got the vaccinations here. Now we need to get in there and deliver these. Doctors are saying plague season is going to be rough this year. Corporations have been able to manufacture products specifically for Sprawl ever since supply increased thanks to the mines. All right, let's head in. A gate to Sprawl should be around here somewhere. Let me locate it for you. Now, these are all locked crates. You cannot access these. As far as I know, there's no way to open them. They're just there. Do we have anything in the back here? We can see that our objective is over on that side, but we do actually have... I don't know what to call these, but, like, I'll call it a Codex Tower for now. All right. Demeter Biologistics oversees all bioengineering, and then we could learn more about that back at Mission Control if we wanted to. Let's get into some combat here. And I'll start... I'm gonna probably hold off on some of these abilities for right now. You know what? Let's use them. Let's try and go through each and every one. Maybe not in order. Now we just need to find the drop-off point. Okay, we've got pawn shops. That's great. I dig the aesthetics. Like, I think things look pretty good. Corporations don't appear to be viewed very favorably around here.
Yep.
Can imagine. I don't see any enemies up front. Let's jump to here. Here's our next objective. Incoming. Okay, we're getting flanked, boys. Flip over to the other side. Let's go bullet time here. I'm actually gonna throw a grenade over here. And we'll throw down the mobile shield as well. Alpha team, we'll have you shoot to the left. Okay. So I may have interrupted the jump over because not everybody made it, but it's okay. We're in this bubble, which basically makes sure that we don't take damage, but we can shoot out of it. And it lasts for a pretty good amount of time too. But remember, all of these things have limited uses, so you don't want to just waste them. But just for the sakes of showing you guys, I'll try and go through as many of them as I can. It appears the drones were programmed to come to this location. Is that what it said? Wait for the enemies to approach, then shoot the barrels. So you're gonna notice these enemies coming down here. And 3, 2, 1. Nice. Basically, it's just showing us there that, hey, you can use the environment to get things done if you need to. This level is kind of riddled with different barrels that can explode, or some will cause, like, poisonous gas. Someone's been stockpiling resources. Yes, they have. These are all locked as well. Now, this mission indicator can be a bit misleading. Like, you'll see it's heading right over here. So you might be inclined to, like, run over here and, like, try to climb this stuff. There is elevation and there are things that we can get onto. But these are not some of those things. Let's grab the Codex Tower here. So Themis, cool. So we can read a little bit more about them back at Mission Control. And now we're gonna start getting into kind of splitting up our squad a bit. I'll try not to keep everybody on the same piece of cover. All right, so here's all those barrels. Let's actually throw some guys here. I'm actually, you know what? Let's swap these guys. It's gonna be a bit problematic because it's gonna take some time. Let's slow her down. Let's put a mobile shield over our guys in the front. Guys in the front, suppress that area. Let's do a headshot over here. And I'll do body hugger on this guy. And then we'll just watch it happen. Okay, very cool. I'm actually not gonna RPG this. Let's actually shoot out the barrel. He's moving. You do have to constantly be assigning things for your guys to be doing. RPG on this group. Looks good to me. Okay, that guy's down. Whoa, boys. Pull back. Pull back. Let's suppress again. And we could do a little heal up while this is happening. Very cool. Okay. Now, there are chances to hit. You may or may not have seen them popping up there. It's a little bit... Oh, we're not done here. It's all based on, like, your accuracy and stuff. And it's a little bit... because it's real time and everything's just happening, like, you're not going to take, like, a 70% chance shot and be like, okay, well... we missed or we hit. It's just, it's basically a reflection of your accuracy. Let's collect all of this. Oh, 100% heal, very nice. So we dispatched of that group rather easily. Personally, I've been through this mission a couple of times to learn all of the mechanics and stuff. I'm really excited to see how difficult this can get. As far as I can tell, there's not an actual difficulty setting. Under the guidance of the six corporations. This is about the wall. That would actually be an interesting read. I'm really interested to see how difficult this can get. This just turned into a level 5 safety infraction. I'm guessing because of all the barrels. Yeah, let's work our way around here. Whoa. Take cover, boys. All right, we don't have the mobile shield. Let's take the headshot. Slow things down a bit. We have an RPG. Let's go ahead and use it. Alpha squad, take the left. Bravo, take the right. Did not want to do that. Let's get in there. So you can see those chances to hit, 63, 68, on the actual lines themselves. Let's suppress this team. I'm gonna actually cloak these guys. It cloaks the whole squad, but it's pretty cool for coming around a flank. That guy actually hopped in there. He didn't see us at all. That's funny. The cloak's really cool. Grenades, mobile shield charge, very nice. And I also like, at least in the early game, it seems to encourage you to use your skills because you do find a fair amount of, like, replenishments, let's say, for the skills that you have. Okay, let's open it up. This view is kind of cool. I do kind of like this, like, kind of over-the-shoulder view almost. I don't think I can fit everybody there. They'll just take cover to the right. Here's where we'll split. We'll go Alpha on the left, Bravo to the right. We have enemies coming in. Let's go ahead and put down a mobile shield here on us. Come back to this side, please. Now these guys, we're kind of pinned around this corner. So let's pull back here. Let's body hugger this. Grenade in the back. Let's cloak up. Cloak's good to move between cover. And of course, we could shoot these barrels with super high levels of accuracy. It's fun though, like, I mean, this sounds obvious because, you know, it's a video game, but it needs to be fun. And this is, like, it's fun to control these guys. And I can't wait for, like, more difficult missions. Okay, more healing, very good. Obviously, it seems like, well, how can you even die here? But the first time I went through here, I got my guys killed because I just wasn't confident with where I wanted to send them and how I should be controlling them. And if you think like, well, it's just because if you've played XCOM, you're going to be fine. That's not necessarily true. Like general tactics wise, maybe, but is there anything else over here? Let's check out the tattoo and needle corner. Needles, noodles. Okay, good. Seems clear. Nice. I think this is a chest we can open. It does pay to explore the levels for sure. I like that a lot, actually. Another heal. That's beautiful. Not just for those codex entries, but as we just saw, some of those loot chests. Always be watching for cover here. Over here, boys. Okay, Alpha team, suppress. Bravo squad, run it. Run it, run it, run it. There we go. Now we can drop off the shipment. I think it's all clear. Let's go. Got wholesale foods. Good translation. Package has been safely delivered. Great work, Commander. Thank you, my friend. AAID, his name is. This is where some of the elevation is. And I hope that there's a lot more levels like this. We do have action across the way. It's way too far. He's gonna run down. It's not gonna be good for him. We got four guys ready to go. And I believe we've got something flying around over here. There it is. I think we've done a good job of using up all of our abilities. You see the cloak, you have 15 seconds of use in total. Which I think is a nice way of doing it instead of having charges. Let's just get to the evac point here. Take out the drone, boys. I'm missing it. Keep missing it. There we go. So yeah, some people may prefer rotating the camera with A and D. For whatever reason, I like to kind of click and drag. It just seems a little bit more natural. But if it's like jittery at all, it's because of my the way that I'm moving it. Oh, there we go. There is a codex over here. Let's go, boys. We don't need the whole squad to go. Let's separate. I'm hoping that there's levels where you have to separate your squad as well. Where it's like you got two guys on one area of the map, two... Maybe it's like you're working towards each other. That was about the heavy guard, I believe. One guy, like, you have one squad on one side of the map, one squad on the other, and like working your way towards the middle. I think that would be cool. Let's evac, boys and girls. So yeah, seems pretty straightforward, but when you play it, you'll see how some of those intricacies come into play. And what is yet to be seen is how difficult it gets. My hope is that we see a huge variety of enemies and increased difficulty. Not just because I'm a masochist, but because I think that that would make things feel... It would just be more challenging. So when you complete a mission, it feels more rewarding, if that makes sense. So, you'll notice that we earned significantly less XP this mission than we did last time. So, I'm not sure if that's just because it's a tutorial style mission or it's just to kind of give you like a boost at the start, but you earn significantly less in this one. So, I'm not sure what determines that exactly, but regardless, you do earn experience as you go and you level up your guys and you want to keep them alive. Now, how does death work? Well, I kind of have an answer. So, the first time I went through, I got two of my soldiers killed. And while they died in combat, they were actually out for 5 days and they had various like medical injuries. You could pay money to heal them faster and get rid of those ailments, but that was a significant cost. The other thing you'll notice is you can advance these days. Now, what happens is when your guys are injured, you can't take them out on mission. So you either have to hire a new mercenary and you have to take four. So you need to make sure that your squad is full. If you can't fill your squad, then you have to advance the days. And when you advance days, you can miss out on missions and things like that. So that's really devastating when your guys get hurt. But yeah, pretty cool. I actually like Merc. It's really fun. I'm really curious to hear what you guys think. I think it's quite polished for early access. Like, I'm very surprised. I've tried like real-time tactical combat games before, like Door Kickers. Was a game that I played a long time ago, and when it first came out, it was not very polished at all. This is a lot more polished than where Door Kickers was at when it first came out. Door Kickers has now been around for like a year, maybe a year and a half, 2 years even, and it's gotten like progressively more substantial and differentiated, and it's really evolved. And I'm hoping that Merc does the same thing. I haven't seen any press about Merc. It's kind of like an accident that I even found it, but I tried it and I liked it and I thought that you guys may like it as well. So I'm curious to hear your thoughts, but yeah, if you have any questions, let me know. I'll have a link for you guys to check out Merc. It's releasing in early access when this video goes up. So you guys can try it for yourselves and invest even more time into it than I just did. But yeah. I'd be happy to try and answer any questions for you or direct you to somebody that can. Otherwise, thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. And hopefully you guys enjoyed the game. We'll see you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.